Welcome to r/TooAfraidToAsk, a brand new subreddit that I haven't checked out before, where people ask others on the internet questions they'd be too afraid to ask to people they know in real life. To kind of show what this subreddit is all about, let's start off with this post here. Is it that weird that my brother and I snuggle? Basically, the title. My brother, who is 23, and I, who's also 23, are twins. We live together, too, so we spend a lot of time together. We both go to grad schools in the same city. Anyway, sometimes we cuddle while hanging out, talking, like if one of us is sad about something, etc., or watching TV. Now, it's not a secret, and my new boyfriend thinks it's extremely weird to be that close with a sibling. He's uncomfortable with it. I think it's gross that my boyfriend is acting jealous of my relationship with my brother. However, we've spoken to some friends and gotten mixed reactions ranging from what the heck to must be a twin thing to doesn't seem that weird. So, I want the opinion of unbiased strangers. Is it that weird that we cuddle? Now, a little bit more context has been added by OP in an edit. I've been told in PMs to include the following. We don't generally spoon unless we fall asleep cuddling and happen to wake up that way. Our other brothers never mentioned it being weird growing up. Our parents were taken out of the picture when we were very young, so we never had their input on the subject either way. The person who raised us never said anything, though. And another edit as well, I do not cuddle with my twin in front of my boyfriend. I think I've held my twin's hand in front of him and sat between them on the couch for scary movie nights, but that's about it. For the most part, if my boyfriend is over, my twin is out with a girl, other friends, or in his room. Or my boyfriend and I are in my room. Mostly we don't spend time at the condo. So it's not that I'm cuddling with my twin instead of my boyfriend. Yeah, alright, if you didn't know what this subreddit was about before, that's what it is. Quite a lot to unpack there. Let's first of all see what the comments down below are saying. Alright, so first of all, I've never seen a comment section so equally split. This is tremendous. I can imagine that the range of opinions are pretty crazy here. Let's see. Define snuggle. Are you guys spooning on the couch or just sort of sitting right next to each other? And then OP has replied, we just cuddle wherever we are at the time. Usually living room or his room, since that's where the TVs are, and we don't really spoon, no. Yeah, and I agree with this comment at the bottom. Spooning is where I draw the line from weird and siblings being comfortable with one another. Not a big deal, to be honest. Just some people aren't comfortable with their siblings the same way. I think I agree with that. Spooning is a bit sexual, realistically. Cuddling is nice. Look, I'll be honest. I still think it is a little bit weird that you cuddle your siblings so much. But then again, as OP mentioned in the original comment and the edit, their parents weren't around. So maybe it does make sense that your brother is kind of like your familiar support rather than your parents, because obviously they weren't there. Look, I don't really know. But guys, comment down below. What do you reckon? Weird start. If you take it out of context, I like cuddling my brother a lot. That's a bit weird. But with context, it makes a little bit more sense. Yeah, exactly. This is the context I needed. Our parents were taken out of the picture when they were young. You were all each other had, and now you're both just used to being there for each other. It's pretty heartwarming, actually. Weird, but I totally get it. There you go. I think this is a good comment to kind of sum it all up, really. It is slightly weird. I mean, I think it's weird as well. I'm trying to figure out if that's society telling me that or my own mind, but I can't help but go, eh, I don't know about that one. That was my first reaction. I was just like, well, it's a little bit dodgy. I'll be honest, like, I don't really go around cuddling my sister. I mean, like, giving someone a hug is different to cuddling. Can we just make that clear, by the way? Cuddling to me suggests, like, you know, you're on the sofa chilling, cuddling for a long period of time. Weird thing to do with your family, is all I'd say. But as this person says, at the very least, be open to the idea that it is odd to some. Yes, from the boyfriend's perspective and POV, that is a little bit weird. Imagine you were going out with a girl and she had a twin and she just was so keen on cuddling him all the time. Yeah, not in front of you, but you know it's happening. It's a bit dodgy, isn't it? With context, it makes a bit more sense. Out of context, I don't know. For your boyfriend to complain about it, he must be around to see it. That is true, unless you're just mentioning it to him. So that means, say you three are watching a movie together, you're cuddling with your brother, while your boyfriend sits on the side and watches you guys. That is weird. And I can see why I'd have a problem with that. Yes, me too. I can't see any instances where your boyfriend would be complaining unless he was the one left out. Maybe, but it's still dodgy anyway. I imagine like a little threesome cuddle. That'd be great. Next up, we've got this post. Why do my parents pull a, you're living on our money, under our roof, and do it when you have your own place, whenever I don't agree with them? So this post is kind of like an entitled parents post. Let's be honest. I'm 15. They cancelled our Netflix subscription. I can't buy more than 2 books in a month. I'm not allowed to wear clothes of my choice or date. Social media is prohibited as well. I can't hang out with my friends more than once a month. I don't have a phone either. We're an upper middle class family, so it's not like money is an issue. Also, I get good grades. I feel guilty whenever I ask for something, be it a novel or new clothes. And then there's my mother, who goes shopping every week and watches shows on her preferred streaming platforms. It's maddening. All right, now my immediate reaction to this is your parents are absolutely in the head. So I can't really phrase it any better than that. That is the only thing I can say. That is so strange, especially given that you say you have a lot of money anyway, and your mom is spending loads of money and watching whatever she wants. You're doing well in school. There's no reason to punish you like this. I don't really get it. Your parents seem mad. That is my initial reaction. Guys, comment down below what you think. As you can see, this subreddit really is very varied. There are lots of different posts, all with questions that people don't really know the answers to and they're too afraid to ask. Obviously, we get stuff like this, stuff like the first one, which is probably a bit weirder. Let's see what the internet thinks though. Limiting books and time with friends is weird, especially books. Books are my friends. Indeed, they are the best. Well, fair enough. That line of comments did get a little bit weird, but I do agree. If you're going to limit something as a parent, surely it's not books or spending time with friends. Like, those would be two things that I would encourage my children to do, surely. Like, that just makes no sense to me. Sure, if you're smashing out video games for 16 hours a day, probably not the best idea. We've all been there. But this, that's something I'd want to promote and encourage. Weird. Yeah, I think this actually pretty much sums it up right here. The parents are going to wonder why OP never calls once they move out. Right? You're living under our money, under our roof. I'm sorry, I never asked to be alive. You decided to have a child and support them. You can't put stupid rules like that on children. It was their decision to have a kid. I completely agree. As a parent, I don't understand giving arbitrary reasons for your actions. Like, I tell my daughter the real reason we can't do X or she can't eat Y. I find that gets pretty good results. I truly don't get the because I said so and that has weight because you live under my roof. My daughter didn't ask to be born. I, partly, made her of my own volition. I owe her, not the other way around. What a great way of thinking about it. That is a difference between a good parent and OP's messed up parents that clearly just don't understand life. All right, next up. What is so bad about living with your parents? Whenever a person is asking for advice about changing their life or how they effed up, they start with saying they're still living with their parents. What's so bad about it? A house is a home for a family, and families ought to stay together. Why is it considered a mark of failure, or misery, or loss? Now, this is actually one that I can relate to a lot, because I've always kind of said this when people have asked me, you know, what's going on in my life right now, as in literally right now when this video is being recorded. I always say, oh yeah, I'm still living at home. I'm trying to move out as quickly as possible. And I was thinking the other day, after chatting with people, like, why do I say that? Why is that my initial reaction to say living at home is a bad thing? When in reality, if I think about it, it really isn't. Like, for me, I've kind of realized that I don't necessarily want to move out. I'm not in a rush to move out. I love my house. I love my family. It's in a great location. All my friends live around here. There's no rush for me to move. So it's like a new way of thinking about it. But the question itself is super interesting because I've always had that line of thinking as well. Not that I'm a failure for not moving out already, but it's a bad thing that I haven't already moved out. When in reality, I don't really think it is. So why is it seen as that? That is the question. Why did I have that initial thought whenever anyone asked me that question? Here we go. Some comments. I don't know. I'm 28 and dad still doesn't want me to go. Same, except I'm 23 and it's my mum. I can do anything I want to do and easily help her with stuff she can't manage alone anymore. Why should I waste my money to live alone when it gives me no benefits at all and only makes it harder to help my mum? It's a great, great question. For me, if I was going to write a list of benefits of moving out and negatives, the benefits would literally just be independence. And I think that would be it if I'm thinking about it. Maybe getting on the property ladder? I don't know. Not really a benefit, is it? Who cares? That's it. The negatives would be so long. I don't know. But here is the flip side. I don't think that's a bad thing, says this commenter. But personally, I have quite a toxic family. And for that reason, I got the F out at 18. So, IMO, you're probably good parents if your children decide to stay with you a little longer. That's exactly right. Same. My parents were trying to arrange my marriage to an abusive butthat from a polygamous family. They constantly lied to and manipulated me. I'm really happy I left, and I regret having stayed in touch as long as I did. That's the flip side right there. Obviously, If your family are horrible and you don't like living with them, and there are loads of benefits, clear benefits to moving out, then I get why your immediate reaction when someone asks what's going on in your life right now and you say, oh, I'm still living at home, would be a negative one. It just depends on how it is, really. I guess it depends on how your home is. I agree with the initial comment saying that your home is for your family home is for you. But then again, if you don't like your family and you want to move out, I get why you'd have a negative reaction to that question. Guys, as you can see, this subreddit is very varied, and that is why I really like the look of it. Because in one video, I can cover so many different things. Look at what's up next. Is it weird that as a dude, I prefer to sit down while peeing? My family says that it is super weird, but I don't know. Oh my God, an OP has also said, to all the people asking how my family knows, they walk in accidentally while I'm using the bathroom. That's it. Maybe lock the door, my brother. Just a little recommendation. And look, there you go. How varied can one subreddit get? From horrible parents to now saying, is it weird that I prefer to sit down while peeing? You know what? I'm impartial to a little sit down while peeing. It's relaxing. You know, I don't want my legs getting tired for standing up for all that amount of time. It makes sense. And also, look, if you want to go on your phone or something, it's much easier to do whilst you're sitting down. It's just chilled. What's the pressure? Sit down. Enjoy life. Enjoy the wee. Now, here's a comment, yeah. It's only weird if you make it weird. So, you're saying take off the Deadpool mask. I think they're saying you should have a zipper in the suit. This is where Reddit gets weird, yeah? Which I love. But this is true. This is true right here. Oh, here you go. You can compensate by standing up to poop. It's a great shout. It really is. And it's something that I might have to try. Lovely. Here we go. Exactly. Nope. Sit there. Browse your phone. Enjoy a few extra minutes of alone time. What's the rush? I quite like going and chilling on the toilet. Genuinely. It's just chilled. There's no pressure. Relax. Watch a video. Listen to me. Simple. And now for our final post of this video. Is it unreasonable to expect not to have to babysit when first dating a single parent? I've always said I've got no issue dating women who have a kid or kids from a previous relationship. But lately, I'm questioning it. My mother was a single mum for a few years before she met my stepfather. And not once was I ever left alone with anyone else she dated, even with my stepfather. She'd been dating him for quite a while before I ever met him, let alone stayed alone with him. It seems like most of the time though, when I start getting together with a woman who has kids, I'm almost immediately expected to babysit. I don't like this for a couple of reasons. First of all, kids are hard work. I work a physically demanding job, 12 hours a day, and on my time off, I want to have a chance to relax, and trying to keep some wild kid from killing themselves isn't my idea of relaxation. I don't like the responsibility, and it skews me out that they barely know me, yet are willing to dump their child off on me. I could be a freaking murderer for all they know, and they're gonna leave their most precious gift with me, having known me for 2 weeks or something? That's just a bit screwed up. If they do that with me, who else have these kids been left with? What have they experienced? Look, I get that having a kid is hard, especially on their own, and I don't mind helping, but I just don't want to be a babysitter before I even get to know them well enough to decide the relationship is worth pursuing. And the worst part is, then I feel guilty as anything leaving the woman, because I worry about who she'll leave her kids with next, who might not be as harmless as me. It's all around terrible. Right, with this one, I'm going straight to the comments. I'm clearly not qualified to answer this question alone. Reddit, help me please. No, it's not unreasonable. I'm a single mum, and it takes me forever to introduce the kids to the guy I'm with. I've never asked a boyfriend to babysit my kids, ever. Yeah, I'd be inclined to agree. Same here. My now husband didn't meet my child till we'd been seeing each other for around 3 to 4 months. He knew I had one, but I wouldn't introduce them till there was more than just a casual relationship. That makes sense. Generally speaking, you should not even be meeting their kids until it develops into a serious relationship. Children need stability. Yeah, that's a great point, actually. That really is a good point. I didn't even think about that. Think about it from the kid's perspective. If you're a kid and your mum is introducing you to loads of new men who she's casually dating, that's a bit weird, isn't it? Maybe just wait until you're completely serious and already together. But then again, I get for the mum that she needs her new boyfriend or person that she's seeing to get on well with their kid, or at least show that you can get on well with her kid, or it's not going to work out long term. I don't know. It's a balancing act, really, isn't it? I think the thing is, it is weird that a woman would want you to babysit after just 2 weeks of knowing her. That is strange. But then again, you don't want to go too long before meeting their kid. I don't know. Tough one. Any experience with this, guys? Comment down below. I don't have much of my own, so that's why I'm a little bit in the mud.
Yeah, I mean, look, here we are. I don't want to say I'm a genius, but this comment here, this string of comments is exactly what I'm talking about. I don't think that's unreasonable. I am beyond shocked that someone would let someone they've known for 2 weeks babysit their child. Seems completely irresponsible. That right away leaves a bad taste in my mouth. Opie replies, right? What if I'm a psycho who beats kids or something? I wouldn't say that though, OP, because that is giving me a little weird impression of you. But I get the general point. I find it concerning that they're even introducing you to their kids that fast. How many guys have been in and out of these kids' lives? Shouldn't be meeting kids until it's serious, a month at least. Azure Magaletti, are you me in disguise? That's my question. Upvote from me. So there you go, guys. That is going to do it for the first episode looking at r/TooAfraidToAsk. A brand new subreddit. I've wanted to change it up for a little bit of time now and give you something completely new. And I hope this was it. Well, it was completely new. Was it good, though? Comment down below. Drop a like on the video if you enjoyed it. Let me know. Guys, with all these 5 posts, please do get your comments in down below because I want to hear your thoughts. That's kind of the point of this. You don't really care what I've got to say. Go read the comments now. Have a look at what the people are saying. Read the comments as you listen to my voice. That's always a shout as well. The comments are very, very clever, much more intelligent and much more sensible than me. That is where you'll find useful information. Now, if you do want some more videos from me right away, check out my playlist of all of them right here. If you're new to the channel and you want to see more videos like this one, subscribe here, and I'll see you guys all tomorrow for a brand new one.